Marie, and today we're doing another one of these. This is the touring car version of the TS500 I did last time. I did some changes to it since I originally did it mostly. The car itself is now using a pushrod engine instead of dual overhead cams, so originally I think it made around 700 horsepower, now it makes like 530, so it's much less, but it should be more drivable. The number's not that big on this one, but yeah, this is just the touring car version of more power. It's on semi-slick tires, because those are closest you can get to actual slicks and automation without having to mod the files. Technically, you can. This car's pretty loud, so actually, before we do that real quick, let me turn down my volume. That should be good. Oops. Big lag spike. That's really fast, isn't it? I have to wait for this to load. Oh, yeah, that's very fast. So that puts it at the top now. Right under, or right above the old TS500, the P2000, an F1 car. Oh, wait, it's that. Oh, that's the P1000. Wait. What? Alright, well, that car must have done really well there. So, yeah, next challenge. Time for the little racetrack thing. So this is actually a proper racetrack, so should do.
Thank you.
Is that actually slower than other TS7? No, that's the P2000. So that makes sense, because that car was actually easy to drive. And this is the P3000, which is harder to drive because it does try to wander a bit. But it was this car. At lower speeds, like at the slow corners, it really likes to have lots of wheel spin. And at high speeds, it likes to understeer quite a bit. Or at least I wasn't using enough steering because I was afraid I was going to just oversteer into a wall and have to restart. So that's what happened there. And it's still a respectable time, though, considering those cars have comparable power, maybe the P3000 is 700, so that's way more. I think it's a fair time. Next chance. All right, now it's gonna test it on like an actual road, so this is a bit bumpier. Okay. It got a bit loose in some areas, but I think it did well. like with the bumps.
Yeah, it was only beaten by the P2000. The P3000 probably had an accident or something. 2 seconds off that car. That car is just really fast. So that wasn't really me being bad on a racetrack. It was just that car being so much faster, even though this is on semi slicks. That's the car's in sports compound. And it's going flying. I'll see you in the next challenge. Alright, let's wait till it lands. Ooh. Don't land it on the wheels. Nope, on its roof. Alright, next challenge.
Another time to drag race it. Should do better than ever. TS shouldn't get too much wheel spin, so. Actually have to be in the leaderboard because I've got all the times written down.
Put them all down on the leaderboard, so I'm gonna have to
do that, and then
we'll see how it stacks up. It's probably gonna be very fast against everything. So yeah, next challenge. Oops. Excellent, pressed F10.
Come on. Right now we have it.
Lots of power, so. Boom.
I know how to get rid of it, I just don't care enough to do this steam thing. But
yeah, 218, it's like down here. Beaten by a Gavril Roamer off-road. Beats the BM9 by 2 seconds, and that's the base model with like 100 horsepower. That's just how much grip matters, because if you go up here, you see 145, that was the Royal Lightning, which is for VAT, and we have some a modded I-Series I made, because I made that mod. P2000, P1000, and a Sunburst. So rally cars still are on the top of this, because there's a BO9 RS, RS806, I-Series. I think those are like when I was like just testing it, make sure it's all good. See, there's an HR Cup, Sport. So they all sit up here, cars that are... Because although there are some cars that just perform better, even though... Because I think that BO9's still inferred. If... I don't know where the P3000 went. Maybe I did issue. Oh, there it is. Found it. Alright, well, next challenge. Trying to test his top speed. I'm not sure what it actually can do. Top speed. I'm gonna say it'd be fair to keep it at 214. Breaking. Yeah, I changed the engine noise on this and it sounds way better than it used to. Like, I hate the automation V8s, they sound awful. If you look inside, you can see the engine. It's also a space frame chassis, so yeah, you can see that that's a push rod. If you know the automation, like, models, like, that's the push rod. The dual red cam looks a bit different than that, so... Yeah, next challenge. Alright, well, time to... This is not gonna be pretty, because this car needs, like, accelerating at a low speed corner, heel spin, because of the power. And you can't, and, like, the fenders don't extend. They don't have morphs that extend, so...
Thank you.
Or should I take that as a 151.8?
You know what? What I'm going to do is I'm going to take that as because I did crash. And it was a 145 on the last checkpoint. So, what I'm going to do, an estimate like 148. I'm just going to add 3 seconds. That estimate should be relatively good to what the time would actually be, probably. So I'll just say it's a 148 point, whatever it was. So 148.35 is going to be its actual time because I really don't feel like that's fair, but I also don't feel like rerunning again, if that makes sense. It does. It should. So.
Because there's a three second checkpoint between these two, so. Where would those checkpoints be? Probably like, I think the average checkpoint was like right here to right here. So probably like 2 seconds.
So actually I'll do, you know what? Yeah, I think that was. Yeah, I'm going to do 147.3. That's what I'm going to do. All
right, next challenge. Challenge.
Now we have West Coast. I actually heard that this map's going to be getting huge optimization changes in the next update, so soon this won't take as long and be as painful. And West Coast in general will be better because I really like this map and I'd love to play on it more. It's just the lag that kills it for me. Why would I play on this when I could play on Utah, which is much better? This is a lag, I'm not sure. East Coast apparently now runs better in East Coast. We'll have to see about that later in the thing. East Coast is mostly forest, so I'm guessing if you have a lower. The reason why these videos are so long in the first place is just due to lag. If I had a better computer, these videos don't take nearly as long. This is 55 seconds. Boom, now I'm at 20.
Thank you.
So that puts it in second place, even with my screw-ups. So it's still a decent time.
What's it second to? Oh, it's a P2000. Should've known.
Anyways, I'm going to be doing the last challenge. So next challenge will be the last. Time to do this.
Thank you.
where that puts it. Ooh, and fur, not too bad. 6 seconds off, what's that, I'm gonna guess? P2000. P2000, yep, that was correct. P1000 gets 3 seconds faster than it.
It's not as fast as those two. Those two are just really, really fast. I suspect when we get more cars and stuff, we'll start placing in between that. Especially the next car, like next car line that we're gonna do since...
I've been doing them as every single trim will get their own video, which means that there'll end up being lots and lots of these videos. And I enjoy driving the cars. Enjoy making them. The next one's gonna be... I don't want to reveal anything too early about the car. But the base, or the highest end model has 450 horsepower, so... It might be able, but it's only rear-wheel drive, so it might just compete with the P2000. I don't think it's going to get the P1000. It might beat this. Not sure. Because that car is a sequential, but smaller engine, probably weighs less. Still, though, this car is not too bad. I enjoy driving it. It's an interesting car, because... It understeers at high speeds, and it tries to oversteer coming out of low-speed corners. Once it gets, like, that's just due to the tires. Those things can't put down the power because they're just not big enough. Bigger tires, more grippy tires, and automation would be nice, because we only have access to semi-slicks, so having full slicks would be nice. I suppose it means I'd have to remake these cars with slicks. Actually, I could just alter their files to have slicks. I might eventually do that. For the time being, I'm just doing pure exports with maybe minor cosmetic changes, like how this has a custom engine noise, and the next car's gonna be a convertible. That's all I'm revealing. That car's gonna be a convertible, so... It's gonna have an interior, which doesn't work, because it's an automation interior, so... I will probably just alter the interior slightly to fit the car better. And just look a bit nicer. Yeah, that's going to be it for this car. I'll be doing the stock car next, probably next week, maybe. Maybe the week after that, because I have to record the video of the race for that car, because it's hosting a stock car competition. And it should be ending soon. I think it ends at the end of this week, so... Yeah. Probably in a week after, I'll do a stock car, and then this car will be done. The TS500 line will be done. I'll update it in, like, the wiki page and stuff. Which will also have its stats, and I'm also going to update the leaderboard, so it's going to have the car, all its times relative to the other cars, and it's a picture of the car in automation and its stats. So you'll be able to see what's actually, how it's actually built. You can obviously tell some stuff. It's got a space frame chassis, it's rear-wheel drive, obviously. Get a big V8, but you'll be able to see more of the build details. So, that's gonna be it. Goodbye.